This is Fly Guy, just looking at the brand new Marvel Studios, the first 10 years, Red Skull. He stands just at 6 inches, and this is obviously the movie version of the Red Skull, not quite like the comic-ish version that we had many years ago. We'll look at him later on in a comparison. Got this very quickly from Dark Side Toys. Awesome bunch. Link underneath in the description below. Check him out. They really did a beautiful job. Packed like a baby. Absolutely gorgeous. So really well done on that. And I got to keep one in the box. So we'll have a look at that. Captain America the Winter Soldier logo down at the bottom there in nice shiny packaging on the box. And Cap's shield there too. And the rest of the box is pretty nice too. Lots of nice trim on it. Kind of matches the trim on the figure itself. We'll get to look at that shortly. On the side of the box, it's got the numerical numbers that we have on this Marvel Studios first 10 years range. There's some text if you want to freeze frame and read that in different versions. And on the back, we basically get the same continual thing that we've seen. We've reviewed things like the Revengers and Hulk Pack and a lot of these Marvel Studios sets already. And all of them have a kind of classic rendition of the movie poster from the original movie they're from. Again, some text there about Red Skull and a nice little snapshot of the movie, which is looking pretty like the figure. It's very hard to get a figure, I think, to look quite like that. But there you go. If you're not buying it from... Dark Side Toys will give you a UPC, but then again, what's wrong with you? Get on and get it. There you go. UPC if you really want to. But again, thanks to them. Did a really good job. Very chuffed. And there's lots more goodies from Dark Side in the next few reviews coming up. So, there is another version of this, and Hasbro very kindly sent a notification through the week that they're sending me one of the San Diego Comic-Con versions. So we'll get a comparison to review pretty soon, and we'll do the two together. We'll do that in that review. But let's get a closer look at this figure. And first of all, first things first, that facial sculpt. I think they've done a really good job. It's just very hard to see. And the one difficulty is the eyes. This is a bit of a facial scan tech that is going on here. It's very hard to see because obviously he's all completely red. And then you've got weathering across the figure. Got a little bit of kind of a plastic something going on there on the side of his head. We'll get rid of that later on. It's just kind of glue or something or paint or whatever. But all in, I think the sculpt is definitely there. I think what comes across is maybe not quite the best, and certainly some of the product shots, and Matt and I that do the 6-inch show on this very channel talked about this. Sometimes when they pose the figures in the glam shots, they can look very weird. But I think this figure is looking pretty solid. It's just a little bit difficult to see. The brow's very heavy, and the eyes are incredibly bright white against that almost quite dark face. But then again, how else do you do that? It's quite hard to get that. Maybe the open mouth would have made a difference. I don't know. That's a little bit harder to do. But it's pretty damn close. And I think, again, for a $20, $25 figure, wherever you are in the world, obviously slightly different. But I think it's still a particularly good facial sculpt. I think they've done a very good, likeable, relatable Red Skull. Far better than this guy. Look at the two of them. I mean, I know he's based off the comic version and he's very accurate to the comic, but yeah, yep, rubbish. We'll talk about that again more as we go on. Anyway, rest of the figure and the detail, beautiful stitching up and down that suit that he's got on, and of course the Hydra belt, looking beautiful there. The sculpt is absolutely beautiful on that, all across the figure. Very nicely done. The piping is raised. It's not painted on. It's raised and molded into the figure, which again is a very nice touch too. So looking very good. And we get a kind of greeny tinge as the camera's pretty much picking up. It's not black. There is black on here too. We've got the Hydra logo on the side of the shoulder there. But we've got black elements to it. We've got red elements to it and the green. And again, that really detailed stitching all across there. It kind of carries down through the legs. I would have thought that would have been red down there too, but I guess not. The fact it's got some kind of stitching-like seams, but it's black there too. And down to the boots of the Red Skull. Now, he comes with a lot of extras in here, and this is where it gets a little bit confusing. Hasbro have tried to kind of please everybody, and I think by doing that, they've kind of missed the point. Yes, it's a wonderful army builder because it's not just one head that you get. You pop this head off, and you get one of the Hydra troopers. Now, there's three different versions in this box. How creepy cool is that? So you get a kind of commandant, I think he is, figure. I can't remember off the top of my head, so don't all berate me in the YouTube comments. But we get this head with this mask on here, one of the troopers, Hydra troopers that we see in the movie. Incredibly detailed kind of stitching-like elements or seams across that. You can see it on the head too. See the little dots all the way around in that sculpt. The sculpt is beautiful. Really nicely done. So that's one head. Next head is unmasked version of that. Let me pop that on. A little bit difficult because everything's new. It doesn't want to stay on. And we get a very generic face there. So it's the same figure there, but without the head, which is good. I'm glad they did it, but you'll get to the point, you'll see what I mean later on, why I'm not over the moon about that. So same head, just maskless. Pop that off. Oh God, there we go. And on with the last head, which is, God, these things are tough to get on. Another maskless head, just with a kind of fairly generic trooper, but with red visor eyes and a very plain lower part of the face. So we've gone from that kind of facial scan tech to this. Now, whilst this is fantastic that we get all this, there is one thing that's missing in the pack, which will become very evident in a minute or two. So we also get this to go with some of those Hydra soldiers, this bodysuit. So let me very quickly, the other Red Skull's taking a jump, and it's very difficult to do this in review, so bear with me. But you have to pop all these on, and pop that over there, and like so, and then pretty much get this guy. And then the weapon. Now this is the other piece that comes with it. We'll look at the whole figure in just a second. Don't worry, I didn't skimp the waistcoat. So we've got gunmetal, we've got silver, we've got black. It's a very nice weapon indeed. On the end, a little tip of silver there too. And around the other side too, you've got black components, silver, and a kind of gunmetal-ish like part down there. Very nicely done indeed. Very chunky, very heavy. Pretty accurate from memory. And again, so now what you have is one of these Hydra goons that you can basically use on the figure. So the sculpting on the, and it's a little difficult to get down, cover that belt, but there you go. That covers Red Skull's belt, and you've instantly got a Hydra trooper, a Hydra captain, whatever he may be. So we've got little kind of ammo pack-like piece up at the top there. You can see that sculpted in some very intricate detail of, I guess, ammo packs all across the shoulder. And then round to the back for this fabulous looking kind of backpack there, I guess, with ammo in it too. So it's a very nice looking piece, very cool. I've not quite got this sitting on perfectly, but you get the idea. It does sit on quite snugly and it looks pretty good. And again, holding the weapon, let's just get that on the hand. It's a very chunky, chunky ass weapon, so I'm not going to bother with posing it too detailed, but there you go, you can grasp the hand. So that hand comes in useful for another aspect again, the Tesseract, which is nowhere to be seen in this pack, which is just bizarrely odd. So this guy looks great. He looks really good. Hydra logo, the soldier, the stitching is well worth it just for this guy alone. But obviously we've got the Hydra, we've got the Red Skull's head, but no Tesseract. Now this hand is pretty much designed to grasp this part of the weapon, but I also suspect that it's designed for the San Diego Comic-Con version, which from memory does come with a Tesseract, as did this one. So the one big flaw with this figure is, I mean, really, we get a facial scan tech head, we get a waistcoat kind of a replacement piece with lovely paint and ammo on it, we get this gorgeous weapon painted beautifully, we get kind of four different heads. We also get, by the way, a trigger finger hand. Oops, trigger finger hand instead of this. So there's a swap out hand too, but no tiny little piece of plastic for a Tesseract? What the hell, Hasbro? That's a very crappy thing to do, I think. And I think it'd piss off a lot of people, and I just don't know why they did it. So you can see it's not really designed for the Tesseract, but it kind of fits. And I suspect that's what they had in their mind when they were designing the figures and saying, well, we'll make one available at San Diego Comic-Con, but you can't miss that out of the mainline figure. Anyway, so there's the old Tesseract. It's just a tiny piece of little blue plastic. Why they missed that out? It's such a key thing for that character. I do not know. It's not a cost thing. I guess it's a San Diego Comic-Con exclusive thing they wanted to keep, but major letdown that you don't get a tiny little piece of blue plastic. Major. Really, really dumb. Really cheap. Makes the whole thing cheap, so that's my point of view. However, this other figure, the previous Red Skull, one thing that is nice, isn't he keeps falling over just now. Head swap time, though this can pop off pretty easily, as can this. And what you can get is your older Red Skull. Can actually have a quite a badass looking suit this time. Looks a much more kind of funky Red Skull. So he can wear this older figure with these god-awful guns. But again, Hydra, all the rest of it. You can see how far we've come, the paint there to that kind of molded version. Quite a bit different. So this works very well, as does the old comic book version. So if you're really kinky and you want to get with it, you can have old crappy comic book grumpy face Red Skull and have him on the new body. And they fit and they work and they do their job. So that's one nice aspect. So all in, beautifully sculpted figure, very nicely detailed, a lot of piping, a lot of nice intricate parts and pieces. I mean, that belt alone is just beautifully sculpted with a little bit of weathering on it, which is just 10 out of 10. Everything about the figure looks pretty good. There's really nothing flaw you can pick apart of it, apart from the Tesseract. So that's the problem with it. In terms of articulation, let me just pop the right head, I'll put the right head back on, but you can see a ball joint with the hinge up at the top there. So pretty much unrestricted movement on this figure. It doesn't really have too much getting in the way, but you can have all the way back and pretty much all the way forward. So there's plenty of movement going on in his head. No real restrictions there whatsoever. Ball joint with the hinge up at the top of these arms does allow it to go up a little farther into the suit of the jacket, but that's as far up as you're pretty much getting. You then get a bicep swivel on each one, double joints at the elbow, making it a very deep kind of, look at that, that's fantastic. How good is that? So an incredibly good, I mean, that's perfection in terms of articulation point. It's a completely articulated joint. None of this Star Wars The Black Series kind of a way down there, First Order Troopers down there. All the way. All the way. So absolutely fantastic for posing, articulation, and toy photography, etc. So absolutely superb articulation there. He's got an upper body kind of crunch. It's a little bit limited, but it does the job. Let me take this off and you'll get a better look at the set and the articulation. Should have done that earlier on. As I struggled to get it off. There we go. Okay. So in terms of upper ab crunch there, then you've got a waist swivel there, which is really just kind of hidden by this plastic-ish skirt-like piece, which is really designed well, actually, and covers that up very nicely. You can see the join for the waist, and then down to the articulation point up at the top of the thighs. Double joints at the knees, very tightly done. So again, great articulation there. And rocking ankles, pretty... flawless ankles and pretty big peg holes too. So Red Skull is an excellent figure. Absolutely excellent. Absolutely highly rate it. Go click the link underneath and pick it up at Darkside Toys. But yeah, I just wish they'd have included a Tesseract and we would have an absolutely pretty much perfect figure. 9 out of 10, I think, overall. Let us know what you think. It was a very long review, but there's a lot in this pack and I wanted to do the comparison too, so... suck it up. You could have fast-forwarded through if you wanted, but there you go. So, let us know what you think of this. If you want to tune into the 6-Inch Show, just click subscribe and the little bell. All will be done. That's it. We'll see you for another review coming up soon. Cheers.